okay, first and foremost, I want to give all honors and praise and glory belongs to my Lord and Savior, whose name is Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahawashai, Bahasham, Wahavaka Kodash. The name of the Heavenly Father is Yahweh, and his son's name is Yahawashai. And honors to the elder apostles of great Millstone that taught me this truth, and to the hopeful elect across the globe, and to the few, the very few brothers and sisters that are listening and learning in the hopes of being saved in these last days. This lesson is going to be called Esau and his Psyops operation. And what do I mean by Psyops? Okay. From the moment you were born, Esau's whole MO has always been a Psyops to control you. Okay. To have you under a spell. But this is the thing. The elect are not going to be under that spell because we've woken up to the truth. Let's look at that word psyops, military actions designed to influence the perceptions. Alright, so the MI6 and so forth, anybody that's working on behalf of Esau, his newspapers, the police force, because the newspapers, you do know they work with the MI6 hand in hand. I mean the police, what they should put out, what they should write. Okay, BBC, all these news programs, and what do? They put Jake out there as what? The face of wickedness. But why? Because he's the devil. Okay, so Psyop designed the influence of perception, so they want to control your perception of what you think. The newspapers, it's all controlled by the same individuals. The newspapers, who do you think they work for? The elites. Okay, the police, who do you think they work for? The elites. And they're lower level masons, that's why they wear black and white checkered hats. That all goes back into masonry. Okay. And they all look out for the brotherhoods. That's why when the police does something, all the other policemen, they back them. Okay. And the attitudes of individuals, groups, and foreign governments. Right? Psychological operation, military operation. So their whole thing is to change your perception, your attitude, your reasoning, your behavior. Okay? It's one big psyops. Okay, so this is how you gotta look at it. Okay? And this is real. This is very, very real. So we're gonna go to Isaiah 10 and 1. Woe unto them that decree unrighteous decrees. So when you're decreeing an unrighteous decree, what's a decree? A decree is a law. Okay? So that's what they're doing. Decreeing unjust laws. Why? Because Job 9:24, the earth is given to handle the wicked. So if the earth is given to handle the wicked, he's going to practice wickedness. Okay? And that's what a decree is. So they decree unrighteous decrees. Right, you have to do this, you have to do that. And where did the decrees come from? You can say the government, but who gives out these laws? The elites. You have the so-called lawmakers, which they're not really the lawmakers. They're given that by the elites, and they cover behind lawmaker. Okay, they hide behind these titles. No, they're given the laws. And what they reenact these laws, and the decree is what? A rule of law. And this man's law is not just. It's crooked. Okay, his court systems are crooked. You have enough money in this court, so you can get away with anything. If you have the right money, if you know the right people, this kingdom needs to go down. Right? So where was that? Isaiah 10, woe unto them that defeat unrighteous decrees, destruction unto those that decree unrighteous decrees, put out unrighteous laws. And what's the example of that right now? That's what you can see by this image. Oh, you need the mask on your face. The first thing was, what was it? Stand 2 meters away. And then anytime you go into a store, people get funny, iffy with you. Now the thing is, what? Back to wearing a mask. And a lot of people, they're not, well, most of the people, they're following them rules, but there's certain people that are not putting on a mask. So there's a small remnant that are fed up. But the majority of people, they just follow. But they believe. Anything Esau tells them, they believe. And you don't have a mask. Now they're looking at you funny. Like you're an enemy of the state. Why? Because it's a psyop. Esau knows. The man's been studying. He's got scientists and psychologists that have been studying the human mind for the longest. How to manipulate. Using certain colors. Using certain techniques. Using certain frequencies. Know your enemy. You're supposed to know your enemy. Esau, the other nations, and our own people, you're supposed to know the enemy. Because the enemy is studying you. The enemy knows you. But he doesn't know the elect. Okay, that's the only thing. Because the elect are of another fashion. It's Isaiah 10. And that right grievousness which they have prescribed, which they've set up within their own little laws. And when you actually go into the new translation, it says, "Woe unto them that decree unrighteous decrees, unright grievousness which they have prescribed." So like the woe to those that have that enact evil statutes. So these are evil, wicked statutes that only work on behalf of them. Because these laws, it's really against us. And really, it's all against. Example, you had the riots. I remember in them riots, something happened. There was an individual. What was he doing? I think he chucked. What did he steal something in them riots? He stole something. Okay. At one of them furniture stores. You know how many years he got? I believe it was 7 years. Seven or eight years. But Edomites, they can be rioting when the football's on. They're causing all this football. They're beating up each other, chucking glasses everywhere. Even attacking the police at certain moments, and nothing happens. You see the double standard. So the laws were set up on Esau to protect Esau, not to protect us. Esau. Unbelievable. Which enact evil statutes to whose constantly record, to those who constantly record unjust decisions. And that's how Esau operates. Because this is right now, this is his world. And that's why, again, it's not mind-boggling, but why would you want to make it in this man's system? This corrupt system. Oh man, never trust your enemy. Let's go to Ecclesiastes 12 and 10. Never. Scripture says never. Don't put your guard down. Okay? He was created to be the devil. He was created to deceive you. Bear me just a minute. Let's go to Ecclesiastes 12 and 10. All one big psychological operation. Okay? They know where we live. You know what? After some time, that doesn't really bother you. They know where you live. They know your address. They know all that. It doesn't matter. Because they're still going into slavery. Okay? You can't outrun judgment. Let's go to Ecclesiastes 12 and 10. Never trust thine enemy. For like his iron rusted, so is his wickedness. So it says never. Okay, don't trust this man, you know. The soul is iron, not the service is wickedness, because iron, it comes back again. Unless it's that tempered iron, that don't rust. Okay. Though he humble himself and go crouching, yet take good heed. Okay. So he humbled himself, or he humbles himself to give you that illusion that he's your friend, and he's the devil. Many who's trying to set you up. That's Esau's MO, to set you up. To get you going against your power. Yet take good heed and beware of him. Okay, look out. And thou shalt be unto him as thou hast wiped a looking glass. Right? Another, a mirror. You wipe in a mirror, it may have some condensation on it, that it may appear again. and thou shalt know that his wrath hath not been altogether wiped away. Because he will show you that. Okay? A double tongue. This man, he has a double tongue. What he says is all an illusion. You know, the suits, you know. You've got the suits, you know, the people that speak good. Really, he has a double tongue. Okay? Verse 4, set him not by thee, lest when he have overthrown thee, you stand up in thy place. Never let him sit at thy right hand. Okay? And that's how Esau managed to get up into power as well and take us down. Never let him sit at thy right hand, and that was done with subtlety. Okay? Lest he seek to take thy seat, and thou at the last remember my words and be quick thereof. Okay? Never trust your enemy. Verse 16. An enemy speaketh sweetly with his lips. Speaking ever so sweetly. Okay? Telling them good things. So you can get your guard down. The enemy always wants you to have your guard down. He doesn't want you to know he's the enemy. But in his heart, he imagines how to have to throw thee in a pit. And the pit equated to this world is what? The system. His whole MO is to get you to comply. By any means necessary. And if slander don't work, then what? Force is going to be used. That's why he has something called a force. An army force. A police force. So they can push his agenda by force. Okay? He will weep with his eyes, but if you find opportunity, tend to cry, he will not be satisfied with blood. Right, because he's the devil, going back to Cain. If adversity come upon thee, thou shalt find him there first. So he would be there, he'd be in the midst of it. Esau's got his hand in a lot of things. You really think Esau wants the brotherhood to come together? Esau, there's a lot of things. He's even putting out controlled opposition. Demonic cast men. He's even controlling them, men that have no integrity. A man may say, shalom, with these sounding like Barry White, looking like Homer Simpson, black ass Homer Simpson. But Esau may have hired him, or hired a whole load of individuals. Okay? To do his bidding, because this is what happens when you lose integrity. This is what happens when you lose faith. You would do what Esau does. Esau sets up our own nation, and there's always been a pattern to come against themselves, to come against your own people. Look at the Boule. Why do you think the Boule was set up? You've got individuals acting dumb, like they never knew about the Boule. Hold on, so you knew about all this other information of the world, but you never knew about the Boule? Get the fuck out of here. Okay, these men are set up. I'm talking about even in the truth. Okay? Your leaders have sold you short. And that's why I'm here, to tell you, you have to be circumspect. If you're not circumspect, you're going to get caught out. And though did he pretend to help me, okay, yet he shall undermine thee. Right? So he's going to belittle you. He's going to undermine you. He's going to, what's the word? He's going to, there's a word for it. Try to discredit you. See, the enemy, his whole thing is, how could he try to discredit the men of the Lord? That's the enemy. That's how the enemy's operating. How can we get others to think bad about who we're against? That's how the enemy operates. And that's why also Yahweh Shai said in John 8:44, yes, ye are of the devil, and the lust of your father you will do. He was a murderer from the beginning. Because this also equates to our own people that have the same mindset as Esau. That's why Yahweh Shai called him the devil. He will shake his head, he will clap his hands. Okay? You never know, he may be shaking their head when they're watching your video. Okay, and whisper much and change his countenance like a witch and a warlock. Okay, be circumspect. Okay, this is a whole psyop. Now let's go to, wait just a minute, Romans 12 and 2. And be not conformed to this world. So this is what Esau wants, conformity. Just conform, put the mask on. You're helping out your family. You're helping out others. Just do us a favor. Okay? And the next thing is going to be the chip. This right now is a test run. And be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. So those that are of the world, and that's why I always say, if someone, look, you're in this truth and you're clearly seeing someone is just of this world, you better get from around them. You better get from around them. Quick. Okay. He's going to be seeking to take your life or to sell you out. And be not conformed to this world. So you've got a bunch of individuals in this truth. They're conformed to this world. Are we, every brother in this truth, are we somewhat conformed in a way that, yeah, this particular thing, you've got to pay your bills. That's conformity. Okay? But I'm talking about in terms of you giving yourself wholeheartedly to this system. That's what it means to be conformed to this world. Because everybody has to work in with this world to get by. Unless you've got your own land, unless you're producing your own. But be transformed by the renewing of your mind. So if you're transformed by the renewing of your mind, you're able to see a lot of these pitfalls. What Esau's doing, what the wicked of our people are doing. That you may treat that which is good and acceptable and the perfect word of the Most High. Right? So now we're going to go to Thessalonians 4. And 1, but after time and season, it's so easy for me. There you go. But after time and season, brethren, you have no need that I write unto you. Okay? For yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord shall come as a thief in the night. That's to those that are aware, those that have been woken up, those that have the eyes out. For when they shall say peace and safety, then sudden destruction cometh upon them. So when people are in their comfortability, and Esau, again, even this, and this is speaking about the return of Yahweh Yahushua. People are going to be in a peace and safety spirit. Then sudden destruction comes upon them as they go upon a woman with child, and the woman is pregnant, and they shall not escape. All of a sudden. But ye, brethren, are not in darkness. This is referring to a hopeful elect, a remnant, that had been woken up, that the day should overtake you as a thief. We are the children of the light. We are the real Illuminati. We are the light, the real light there is. We are the ones that are bringing you the true light, the truth, the wisdom. Okay? And the truth of the day. We are not of the night, not of darkness. Because Esau, he's of the night, he's of the darkness. Okay? And the scriptures tell you what, Job 5 and 12. Okay? Those that meet within the day, but broke in darkness, they meet with darkness in the daytime. What's that darkness? There's secret legislation that they're pushing out. And you notice this year as well, as soon as we came into this season, straight after spring, straight into the winter, what did they have? The demonic ass meetings, G20, and the other COP21 or whatever they call it. These were demonic meetings of how they're going to speed up this new world order. And their whole plan is to keep you under them, to keep their power and to keep you subjected unto them. That's what it's about. But ye brethren, turn unto me. For we are not of the night nor of darkness, therefore let us not sleep as do others. Because everybody's in a lackadaisical state. They're sleeping, but let us watch and be sober, watching for the signs. For they that sleep deep in the night may be drunken in the night. Okay? And that's how we don't want to be. We want to be alert and actually know what's going on around us. Right? So with this session, I hope this was edifying, and yes, this is one big, okay, Psyop that Israel has. Until the next time, better one.